Hey guys, Matt Cyrus here, and today, Bailey and I are back for Anime Person Reality Part 3 of talking about Hensuki.
Yeah, it was meant to be back last week, but buses changed their schedule, so I'm surprised you didn't do it without me.
It's hard not to do it without you.
Okay, I'll take that as a compliment.
Well, it's just because I've got someone to talk to, really. Because, talking by myself, it's hard. I can't talk by myself, otherwise I basically go silent.
Yeah, I understand what that means.
That's what always happens in my gaming videos. I literally talk a max of, 15 minutes in a whole video.
Yeah, I know what that's like.
And a video is, an hour. So it's just yep.
Yeah. Alright, so we're on episode 6 here. I thought we were on episode 7, but no, we're on episode 6.
No, we're on episode 6, because episode 5 ended with the introduction of, I don't know, slipping on the paper and landing on Keiki.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Keiki. Yeah.
So Ayano puts on...
Ayano.
Ayano?
Ayano.
Ayano, sorry. Ah, oh, God. Really should have watched this series again. Ayano puts on...
You had the time to.
...in school and... And generally adjusts a room to how she likes it.
And, think it's just OCD sort of stuff.
Yeah, I'm like that at times, where I'm just trying to fix up things the way I want them to.
It's not going
to
be that, though.
So, KK asks Okata Sensei if she saw any students around the club building on May 7th, because he's still trying to...
Yeah, he's still trying to figure out who Cinderella is.
Yeah, who Underella is.
No! We're not making it a thing!
It's a thing.
It is not!
It sounds better, yeah.
It sounds wrong!
Yeah, well, what would you prefer, Pantyrella?
That's even worse!
Yeah, no, so stick with Underella.
I'm sticking to Cinderella because that's what they call.
Oh, well, it makes Underella makes a lot more sense.
I'm glad you did write the show then.
Yeah, me too.
It would go from an M rating to an R rating plus rating.
Oh, I'd be traumatized.
You'll be traumatized by yourself.
Yeah. So Ayano happened to be in the connecting hallway to the club building, but
it doesn't really put her. In the building, though, that's the problem.
Because the building's
it's massive.
Yeah. No, I honestly don't know, sometimes where's what, you know? Because.
And the teacher doesn't specify what time either. Mm. So it's there's not much of a hint there.
And it's let's just leave KK to connect the dots. He can do it, he's a big boy. So Ayano repays KK for saving her from. Injury with homemade sweet she made, and when I was watching this, I was like, oh, this is not gonna be like a boring world where the concept of dirty jokes doesn't exist, is it? I was like, oh, no,
it's not, it's not.
Yeah, thankfully,
it goes the slot drug route,
yeah,
in a sense.
Yeah, so Ayano hugs and sniffs Keiki to make it through the afternoon,
and literally, she says, I'm recharging,
yeah.
I think I delivered some of the best deadpan lines in this whole show.
It's a bit like when you're watching, you're just like...
It's funny just because of how deadpan and fourth wall breaking she is.
Yeah. It reminds me of Bender from Futurama, you know, where he drinks alcohol, because it's like, alcohol refuels my cells, my power cells. And so she has to smell.
Also, I just went with the next point. Kaharu somehow took pictures... from behind a cat. And it looked like a giant cat because it's like a whole bunch of photos and it's all just zooming in on her eye, which is just what?
Yeah.
It's a good way of doing a transition in a sense, but why?
She's always taking photos. It's
it's her character trait.
Yeah, I know it's a character trait, but it's like, you want to get a better position for a photo than, you know?
Behind a cat.
Yeah. Why don't you hide in the bushes like a normal person and take the pictures, or in a tree?
Hey, at least it's not, it's sort of similar to the character from Charlotte with the video camera. She's
from Charlotte.
It's a superhero anime, basically.
Okay, I know an anime character named Charlotte.
From what?
From Infinite Stratos.
Oh, yeah.
You ever see that?
No.
It's a pretty fun series. Okay, so, Ayano constantly runs into KK.
Like, how does she know where the heck he is?
It must be a coincidence. Either that or it's plot-driven, you know? Yeah. It's a coincidence because the plot demands it.
Like, this one, like, she just sort of walks into him. Yeah. So I think it is just a coincidence this one happened. Like, it's not... Like, I did say constantly, but it's like... Most of them are accidents.
Does Koharu get some of these photos without being questioned why she's doing it?
Yeah, there are some photos in there where she's literally just right in front of the person.
Unless it's like the camera's at like... Unless imagine like she's 50 feet away and the camera has amazing zoom.
She has proven that she has that type of camera.
Yeah, it's just like... like, should it's be, like, imagine a satellite, you know, and it's like an orbital satellite and you can look from space down to Earth at some places. It's like, the zoom's like that. It's incredible. Yeah.
And just imagine if she grew up to be a sniper or something like that.
Oh, man.
That'd be impressive.
I wouldn't want to be caught in her scope.
Yeah, because she wouldn't be taking photos, she'd be taking shots.
So, Ayano is a character type known as a Gapmo. Or Gapmo?
Gapmo.
Gapmo. What's a
Gapmo? I don't really remember. I didn't even look it up. I didn't look up what a Gapmo is.
No, I have to turn on my phone to look it up.
But it's a certain type of Mo. Mo character.
I know there's a Moe hairstyle.
She sort of has that.
Yeah. So KK trips on a tripwire Yuika set up.
Yeah. And I don't know how she set that up.
It's
not that hard, really.
And so Yuika blames KK for Dream.
For Dream KK.
Dream KK. Telling her how to get bigger boobs. Oh, yeah, you gotta exercise them. They're like he muscles. Was, you
basically, what Dream KK said, though, is massage them.
Oh, yeah, that was just...
So, as a punishment, Yuika massages KK's chest.
It's like, oh, no, there's...
It's like getting pleasure from a girl.
It's like, be gone. Be gone. Be gone, incestuous.
I don't think your phone is working.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it is. Okay, what is...
The Gapmo.
Gapmo.
Gapmoe, I think it's actually pronounced.
KK ends up grabbing Yuika's left boot by accident because he's trying to get her off.
Yeah, he's trying to get her off.
Like, get off me. It's like, no. Reminds me of SAO. Remember when Asuna comes through the portal? And
He's like, what's this? And he keeps going.
Yeah, and he slaps me. He's like, huh? It's like, oh, no.
He didn't mean for that to happen.
Alright.
But yeah, so Yuika ends up calling him a rom-com protagonist for his actions.
Who doesn't love a good rom-com?
But it's a better joke because this is a rom-com.
Yeah, The Wedding Singer, Adam Sandler, Drew Barrymore. That's a rom-com right there.
No.
So what's it called?
A Gap Moe.
Alright, let me look this up. Yeah.
And so, and Ayano, it's like, she's on the school club board, I think it's called. I don't remember exactly.
Right. So, it means affection born of inconsistency between different aspects of the character. The classic one is tsundere, where the gap is between romantic affection and violence, physical or psychological.
Oh, so it's just like, something you add just to the character list.
Yeah, so it's like born of inconsistency between different aspects of the character. So it's like, okay, you like this character. What do you like best about her? Her tsundere tendencies or her shyness? Kind of like that.
Okay. So yeah, I don't know. It's like on the school board or something like that to manage the clubs because she comes around and does an audit. Of the Shadow Club room. Yeah.
And, Yeah, and so Ayanoto asked KK to volunteer for trash pickup around town, which technically, if you're asking someone to volunteer,
it's not inappropriate. They're not volunteering. Oh, yeah.
If you ask, it's like, mate, I need you to do some would you like to do some volunteering? It's like, no, I don't. Too late, I already asked. Get out there.
And then Sayuki tags along.
Oh, yeah, Sayuki. Sayuki and KK. And so...
And I don't know, trying to make Sayuki jealous in this situation. Because she's hugging Keke's arm.
You know, just like the big... just like pressed into the breast. You know the hugs. You, if you've watched anime, you know what hugs that mean. Right, so where were we?
I skipped this one. Oh my gosh, yeah.
Ayano breaks the fourth wall to say she's wearing white panties after Sayuki said she's wearing black panties. Oh yeah, I remember that. So
in that moment, it's just dumb.
Yeah. So Sayuki, she, you know, like a bad girl, she gets hyperactive like a dog and she's licking KK on the face. She's trying to get her off and then she ends up falling on... They end up falling over, and she's on top of him.
Yeah,
and then for some reason, I don't know why...
She literally licks him from the bottom of the cheek to the top of the cheek.
Yeah, and then for some reason, I didn't even know why he learned this. He learns this special technique...
To get dogs off him.
Yeah, and it's like, how is that a technique if not a fetish, you know what I mean? Like a dog fetish.
You gotta remember... If you want to get a dog off you, grab the butt and massage.
What did I walk
into? Oh, hello. Hello. That was bad time for you to join.
I might like this chat already.
Hey, we're doing a podcast right now. We're talking about Hensuki.
An anime.
I see. I'm not familiar with this stuff.
It's very kinky.
Yeah, it's pretty weird, too.
I'm sure.
Yeah, well, it's anime. What do you expect?
Yeah.
Exactly.
But as I was saying, to get a dog off you, you get grabbed the butt and massage it.
Which is just like, what? Yeah. That's weird ass. And so then...
Is that an unintentional joke right there?
Yeah, it's something. So Sayuki, like...
So he does this to...
He manages to get her off him. She falls in the water and he's like...
No, she just falls on the ground.
Yeah, falls on the ground, not the water. Sorry. And he's like, oh, F this shit, I'm out.
Yeah, Ayano's the one that falls into the water.
That's right, Ayano. So...
It's just dumb.
Yeah, so after she falls in the water, Kiki gives Ayano his jacket to cover a wet shirt. But she stands there smelling it, which is just like... Oh my god, you don't give that back. That's not what it's for.
I just to let you know, we basically spoil the whole anime anyway.
Yeah, because we're going
so even if you
episodes.
Don't watch it. Yeah.
Alright. Good to know.
You can't we give you like 2 weeks to pre watch it though before getting into the anime.
Because the scientist here is a YouTube channel, so
yeah.
You know, and you've already uploaded the...
Part 2.
Yeah, part 2. So you can, if you want to check his YouTube channel out, then watch the other videos first.
Yeah, full playlist, Anime versus Reality. There is one video missing because it got corrupted.
Which one?
I think it was around in the 20s or something like that.
Ah, okay.
But it's just one episode that we lost.
I feel like I've sort of just like... I feel like I've jumped into like a radio call or something.
Oh yeah, we normally go for an hour with most of these.
Except for one episode where we went for nearly 3 hours.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Wasn't that like 2 hours, 12 minutes or something?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Hours.
Long.
It felt like 3 hours.
That's because the scientist likes to get every detail down.
Yeah,
we talk about it.
I have a problem where I get all the details down because I watch a lot of cinema scenes.
If you're going to name yourself the scientist, you might as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the main reason why...
I was thinking he should, because he's, the YouTube channel is TM Scientist, and I was telling him he should change it to TMI for Too Much Information Scientist.
No.
Yeah, that'd be a much better name.
No, the TM part is short for the mad, so it's the mad scientist.
Oh, but I think Too Much Information Scientist sounds better, if because you go on all the anime. Is
you want to get this video taken down for a fight happening on screen?
No. Oh, people love that.
You guys have got yourselves a subscriber.
Nice. Bailey here has also got a channel of his own, Toa Gamer Junkie.
Yeah, well, I got to get a new laptop to fix my... I gotta get a new laptop because my other one broke.
We're also planning to move this from Amino over to Discord at some point.
Yeah, when are you doing that?
After our break.
Oh, okay. When's the break? After this anime?
After Interspecies Reviewers.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So, where were we on this?
We're down here.
So, KK tells Shomo about his investigation into Ayano. And he doesn't know...
He doesn't really get any information ever in this whole series. It's more the information just gets handed to him by other characters.
Yeah, like the panties.
Yeah.
Just get handed to him.
Yeah.
So, Ayano runs into KK and Shuma, but weirdly runs away from KK when he approaches her.
And I think... And we find out later that it's because... smells.
Yeah. So, Ayano thanks KK for the jacket with apple pie. When was the last time I had apple pie? It's been years.
I don't think I've had apple pie.
You've never had apple pie?
I've had apple pie, but not in ages.
Alright, well, we'll just end the video here. We're going to get some.
Just take the laptop. We're doing the podcast on the move.
Yeah, we're doing it on the move. Get like a trolley just.
Oh my god.
Alright, so Ayano constantly breaks the 4-4 to tell the audience mundane things about herself.
Yeah, it... Probably...
Which matches her character.
Yeah, it's the best thing about her character.
It's like her ego, you know what I mean? It's like... Not like ego, but she's... Like, yes, me. Know this, know that. Things about me. You know, just...
Oh my gosh.
I wouldn't. I'm probably explaining it badly.
Yeah.
You know what I mean. Yeah. So Ayano falls asleep hugging KK's arm,
which she did not intend to have happen in this situation.
And she has him entrapped.
Because she's taken him to the room that's like that she was working on at the start of the episode.
Yes, and with the jaws of life wrapped around him, KK has no choice but to fall asleep.
Yeah.
And so he wakes up to Ayano reaching into KK's underwear after taking his pants off. So she's drunk.
It looks like she wants to give him a...
I was about to just jokingly say that that's some kinky shit, but I think it doesn't even need to be said.
Yeah. Well, it's not what you think.
Well, it looks like she's gonna give him a BJ.
Yeah, but no, that's not what happens. It's even more weird than that.
Yeah, like a BJ would be normal in this situation.
Yeah. Okay, so you can see, she has this fetish for boys' body odor. She just likes the smell.
Yeah, she likes the smell of boys' body odor.
Musk fetish
alert. And I say this is not the worst fetish to have if you're trying to find a relationship.
Oh, it's not. I don't want someone like that. I'll be locking down.
No, for the guy.
I'll be locking down my clothes. Like every time I do the laundry, I'll be like, gonna get a basket for lock. Just lock it up when I get to the washing machine.
No, but if you live in the same house as your partner and they have that smell
going. No, I wouldn't want a partner like that.
I would not mind it because it's hey, I can shower much less often.
Whatever partner I have, you can have. You can take it.
I don't like to shower.
Showers just can be annoying sometimes.
Yeah, like, I mean, like, if I'm not going out anywhere...
That's pretty sus there.
Yeah. Like, I mean, if I'm not going out, like, if I'm staying inside for like, a day, if I'm not going out anywhere, then okay, yeah, I'm not going to waste time having a shower, but 9 out of 10 times, I'm always having a shower. Because, you know, of course, like, I gotta go to work, I gotta make the money.
We broke the dirty boy. We broke him.
Yeah. Alright, so yeah, so, and so she basically drugged him with these cookies.
And also, no, it was chamomile tea.
Oh, the tea, not the cookies. But
yeah.
And she rearranged the room to make...
Sense. And I think she used, like, I think it was jasmine essence that she used.
Yeah, but she rearranged the room to make him fall asleep.
Yeah. Sure. And she used the color pink as well.
Yeah.
Because, like, pink's a calming color.
Yeah. So now we're on episode...
We're on episode 7. We're past the underwear.
Yeah, so Kaharu, Operation Conclusion episode. So Shoma and Kaharu are now really close friends. That's
good. Just to explain what we mean with that is Kaharu's older than Shoma, but Shoma has a lolicon.
But she looks like a lolly, but she's not a lolly, she's older.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Well, she is a lolly, but she's not a young lolly.
Yeah, she's a granny lolly.
No.
Nah. Like that one character from, like, Smile Cafe.
Smile
Cafe?
I haven't heard of that.
Is that... I don't remember if that's what it's called. You remember that meme where it's like the smile, sweet...
Oh, Blend S. Blend S.
Oh, is that what that's called?
Yeah.
Okay. Blend S.
No, I haven't heard of that one.
I've listened to the opening a few times, so I know it really well.
Okay.
Like, openings, I have very good knowledge of.
Yeah. So Kyoke, he has to go on this double date with Shoma and Kaharu.
And
in order to get
he's trying to pick
together.
Which girl to take.
And, like, all the girls are nut jobs, so it's like, which one is the least nutty? Which one of these bats are the least nutty that I can take?
And he chooses Sayuki.
Which is like, yeah, Sayuki, yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
Totally my shit, but...
Barely here wanted Keiki and Sayuki to be together. Yeah. At the end, which he sort of got.
Yeah. Not, that's not the way.
It's not how it ends, though.
Nah. So, Sayuki almost spills Kaharu's secret about the lolly.
Yeah, and she accepts a taiyaki as payment to keep it a secret. Basically, a taiyaki is...
Like a fish.
Fish-shaped pancake.
I heard about them filling. From To Love Ru. There's a character, Yami, she always eats them.
Yeah.
That was the first time I heard of taiyaki.
By the way, in Demon Wonderland, they have red bean buns, and I have found them. I have found
where
they sell red bean buns. I haven't tried them yet.
There's a place in Harbour Town they sell, there's an Asian store.
There's a place just over in Helensvale now.
Yeah.
That has it.
Because I remember my boss was like, oh, you're going to go to the shop and get these Lotus buns.
But yeah, I just wanted to bring that up because, like, the red bean pancakes that over at the sushi place, I found those when I was looking for red bean buns because of the whole a moment in Dead Man Wonderland.
Okay,
that is just ingrained in my brain. But I won't do it now. I'll save it for when we get to Dead Man Wonderland.
So Sayuki accepted KK's invite despite never having bowled once in her life.
Oh, no.
It's like that she just wanted to be there with him. So, you know, it's like, oh, yeah, we're going to enter one of the seven gates of hell. Sign me the hell up. Pun intended. So Sayuki sets a penalty for the winner. Getting tongue-tied here.
So basically, whoever wins gets to draw on the loser's face.
Whatever they want. And the person who comes third has to do what the person who comes first asks.
Yeah.
And you find out Kaharu is really good at bowling.
She's just getting strikes.
Yeah, and Kaharu... Are you sure it's Kaharu is filming the whole day?
Yeah, she is. Because it's her bag.
And, oh, that's right. Yeah.
You gotta remember, she's the camera person.
That's right. So Kaharu won the game of bowling, and she writes on Sayuki's face the three,
I have big boobs.
Which is I have big boobs. Which is,
Sayuki is the character with the big boobs in this show.
And they are spectacular.
Oh, there always has to be one.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, you missed the part where we talked about the fact that KK had to reach in there for a key.
So Kaharu deleted the incriminating photo of KK and Sayuki the day he promised to help her. So there was this thing where this guy KK and this and his friend Sayuki. Sorry.
What?
I was thinking of the other friend, sorry. So, KK has to reach in to get the key.
Yeah.
And the key is in Sayuki's cleavage.
Yeah.
And then she's, like, dressed up in this, and she's, like, basically just bound herself
thing
together.
Thing is, though, somehow he's elbow deep in
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's like, how the hell? It's like, is it a black hole or something? You're getting sucked into the infinite void?
I think it was. Yet somehow he got his hand back from that.
Yeah. Somehow.
It reminds you of, have you seen Borat 2?
No.
Oh, Borat's going to the daughter. If you put your hand down there, it will suck you up whole, like a black hole. So if you can't do that.
Where are we at?
It wasn't as good as the first one, but it was still a fun
movie. Oh, yeah, so...
I don't know, we got distracted by black hole boobs.
Yeah. By the way, you know your voice is being recorded, right, by the mic that we have?
Yeah, no, I don't care.
Good. I don't want to get into legal trouble.
Okay. My voice is on the internet anyway, so whatever.
Okay, where are we?
We're here. But yeah, so just as a note, I put this in as a note to mention, for females in Japan, wearing the color pink increases their chances of finding a boyfriend. Or getting accepted when they confess
their
love.
Yeah, but why is it pink underwear? Like, that increases the chance?
Yeah.
It's like a lucky charm? It's innocent, even though it's their underwear.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which is like something you can't really see, so it's like, oh, okay. Like, I understand if it was like a shirt.
Yeah, it's
a shirt or a ring or a necklace or something, you know?
No, it's gotta be the underwear.
Yeah. It wouldn't be Japan otherwise.
So yeah, Kaharu reminds Shoma of the day they met.
1 year ago. And so...
We get to see the moment where she lost her hat. So and it landed in a tree.
So she loses her hat. The wind blows it up into a tree. Shoma gets it, and it was like love at first sight. But then,
yeah.
But then after that, he's like, "Oh, you've lied to me. You filthy lolly."
Yeah. So she tells him
the truth, and he's like, "No, I only like."
He
lollies.
Rejects.
Yeah. It's like, "Be gone, fart." And she ends up crying. She's upset. It's like, why does nobody love me?
And we also get to see the growth of her obsession.
Yeah.
With Shoma.
And then Shoma ends up finding it later on. So KK, he talks bad about his friend Shoma to Kaharu.
He did want to see her again after that day where he got the hat for her.
Yeah.
And he went back to the exact same spot. But she's hiding in the bushes, just looking at him.
Oh, yeah. Those binoculars.
I don't think it was binoculars. She was just there.
Yeah, but that makes sense. Like, I know she didn't have binoculars, but it's like...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna... So, KK laughs at Shoma's misery after Kaharu says he's the worst.
Yeah.
And then... Shoma turns on the lights.
Oh, yeah.
So he's like, maybe we can start off as friends and see how the relationship develops. And so you think, okay.
And he's like, why is it so dark in here? Yeah. And so turns on the light.
And she's got all these photos of him. Like, not photos, more like posters.
Well, photos and posters and slideshows.
Of just a guy all over the room. And he's like, oh, no.
He is not happy.
F this shit, I'm out. It's like, I'm gone.
Yeah. And we're on episode 8.
Yeah.
Hey, we're only a half hour.
And then you find out KK's bed has a secret compartment under the mattress.
And then, in that compartment, he's got the.
You know, it's funny. Every time I hear the word KK, all I can think is this.
Yeah. The dog from Animal Crossing.
And I haven't really played Animal Crossing. I know that
there was actually, his name's actually pronounced Keke. Keke, I think it is.
I know there was
Keke. Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a lot easier to say that.
I don't know much about Animal Crossing. What's that from Animal Crossing?
Is that from Animal Crossing?
Yeah.
I never really played it. Like, I know there was this. You alright?
Sorry, that song just made me need to cough.
You gotta make it, don't die.
Yeah. Yeah,
you're killing me with music, man.
So episode 8, so KK's bed, which I just said, has a secret compartment in the mattress where he's hiding.
He's hidden the panties and the love letter that he got.
Yeah, from Underella.
Yeah.
Which sounds a lot better. Because it's basically like kind of like a rip on the Cinderella story where, you know, Prince Charming has to find the right foot for the slipper.
Except in this situation, it's the right crotch for the panties.
Yeah, basically. And I think it's better to say Underella than Cinderella. It sounds a lot better. Makes more sense.
But the show uses Cinderella just to keep it mature.
Yeah. There's nothing mature about this show. Like, it's over mature.
I was gonna say,
well, they have to keep some elements appropriate. Otherwise, no one could ever watch it.
Yeah.
So, it'll get an R18 plus rating.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Yeah. So, KK walks in
I suppose it doesn't already.
Yeah.
Oh, don't worry. The next one definitely had one, but somehow got dropped to an M15 plus.
So, KK, after he gets out of his room,
He's going down to the bathroom.
Yeah, and he ends up, he doesn't even knock.
M15 plus, where are you guys?
We're in Australia.
Oh, yeah, I'm not used to that rating system.
What's your rating system?
By the way, you're sort of half off screen now, mate.
Sorry.
Just move your chair over.
What's your rating system?
Well, I'm in America, so the closest equivalent's TV-14.
Oh.
Okay.
That actually does make sense. I've seen that sort of rating system before.
Yeah. You in the good part of America, or is like, are you in a place where everything's just going to hell right now?
It's difficult to say.
You don't have to.
I think good, but...
I'm going to go and close the front door. Because, don't want noises like that interrupting.
Alright, well, just make sure you stay safe, because there's a lot of just... Like, because I live in Australia, but I, like, listen to the news, just podcasts and that. So, yeah. Just be careful.
Let's just hope you're not in Flint, Michigan. However that's pronounced. I cannot say Michigan.
Flint, Michigan.
I just said
and
it.
You just said it.
But you know what I mean.
You said it just fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's just hope you're not in Flint, Michigan.
Yeah.
Because of the whole water
Flint,
thing.
Michigan.
Okay.
Good.
So KK walks in. So he's got to go to the bathroom. Rather than knock, he just walks in and he discovers his sister, Mizuha.
It's the classic.
Getting
walking the wrong door.
It's like he didn't even knock, the idiot. He's just like, enters. And it's not like, okay, this is an accident.
She doesn't really get angry either.
Yeah, and she's just like, oh, hey, sup, bro, you mind,
you mind getting out?
Yeah, could you, GTFO for me? Thanks, I appreciate it.
Yeah. On the TV in the anime, we find out that Kaharu's family runs a construction business. Which is probably why she has so much money.
Yeah.
To basically afford high-quality camera, and also a giant printer.
Well, it's not her money, it's her parents' money.
Payments.
Yeah.
Allowance.
Yeah, the allowance that she gets.
Yes, you need to.
It's sort of like,
imagine...
remember the character in Ichijou that had the helicopter show up?
Imagine if her parents are actually using their daughter to, like, blackmail other people just, like, by sneaking and taking photos, and it's like, yes, I got the blackmail material, here's your allowance, $100,000, go spend it on what you want.
That would be the...
Wow.
That would be a good backstory. Secretly evil.
Yeah.
No, but she's like, she doesn't know that she's doing the illegal thing.
Yeah. And so then, this is like, well, on the TV, the sister, she goes, oh, big bro, I was just wondering, you know, did you, when you so callously entered the bathroom without knocking and saw me undressing, did you think my green panties looked good? And he's just like, yes, yeah, sis, 10 out of 10. It's like, oh my god. Well, he doesn't say those.
No, he just says yes.
But it's casual like that. Because it's like,
Because they're brother and sister.
It's like, man, I don't want to see my sister getting changed. Like, I mean, right now she's 4 years old, so. Like, yeah, that. I mean, yeah, but when she's a teenager, obviously, like, I'm going to be an adult. It's like, no, yeah. I don't want to see that.
So, yeah, Misa acknowledges the fact that Keiki didn't mean to walk in on her, so it avoids the cliche of...
Why didn't she lock the door? Do doors in Japan not have locks?
I don't know. That's the thing. The front doors have locks.
Is that like what when they're building the houses? Okay, you're buying this house on like the purchasing agreement. Yes, you have to buy your own food and supplies, move your own furniture in, and there are no locks on any of the doors. Are you okay with all of these?
Yeah.
But you got like a lock on every door in your house?
Except the bathroom.
Like, because I'm...
Well, I'm living here in Australia, basically every door has a lock.
Yeah, well, not where I was staying. Not every door had a lock. Like, most of them did.
Yeah, most doors have locks.
Yeah, that's because... Because this is, it's not your house. It's like a rental thing, you know?
Yeah. Although, technically, I'm pretty sure...
Even if it's a rental thing, though, usually in America, like, the front, back doors and the bathroom will all have locks, but nothing else usually does.
Yeah... Japan's just weird, I guess.
Yeah, well, to them, we're the weird ones.
Yeah. Although, I'd prefer to move to Japan, so I'll join the weird train.
Yeah. All aboard the lolly train. That's what Shoma
wants.
No,
don't say it like that.
Yeah, that's what Shoma wants. Shoma's the one that wants it. I'm just channeling my inner Shoma to say the words.
Don't.
Yeah.
Don't.
Yeah, no.
That's just wrong.
Yeah, it's only if they're older.
This whole thing's wrong so far.
Yeah.
And don't worry. Once we get past this one and the next one, we're gonna be getting out of this content.
Yeah. So, Mizuha. What?
Nothing. Just keep going.
Yeah. Right, so Mizuha acknowledges the fact that Keke.
Oh, I already mentioned that.
Sorry. Keke asked Mizuha what she would do. Because there are these other girls that like him, and he's given her examples of the... He's telling her about the girls, and he's just, like, asking what she would do.
Yeah.
If she was in his positions, and he's like...
Like, would you make a girl your pet?
Well, it's like, yeah, what would you do if a girl wanted you to make her your pet? And she's like, call the police.
And the same for becoming a girl slave. Call the police.
Yeah, because one of them wants to be his pet, and another one wants him to be the pet.
And also the sniffing the panties.
Yeah, and it's like, nah, I'm calling the police on you.
And the last one, he says she said, call the police again, but it's a joke.
Yeah, okay. So...
Because he literally just says, even wanting to fall in love.
Yeah.
And it's just like, call the police.
I'm
probably going to head out and join a different chat at some point, so... You guys have fun with the rest of the podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry if we traumatized you.
That's
all right. Yeah, if you want to be traumatized more, make sure you subscribe to the Scientist channel.
Right.
Some sweet traumatization for you.
Alright, see ya.
See ya.
Alright, so what did you put? Pisces lucky items are pink trinkets and for... Leo's, it's keychains.
So
all the Japanese girls who wear pink underwear are Pisces.
No, that's just what the TV says.
Superstition.
Yeah, because for some reason the news network does the horoscopes stuff.
Okay.
And Libras have to watch out for certain visitors. Which is a perfect way to introduce all these girls into this one house over the whole episode.
Yeah, so Saiki goes to KK's house because she's bored.
But we find out that...
And then she comes with a bag of treats, which, like, I know it sounds like a dog, which is, like... It's her bag of treats, basically.
She's got the fake dog ears,
Sayuki,
dumb paws, and tail.
So she gets to his house and she wants some love and affection. It's like, if you don't treat me like how I identify as, like a pet, I may be a human girl, but I identify as a
dog.
Yeah. And it's like, if you don't use my...
Or should we use the actual term for female dog?
Oh, yeah, if you don't use my preferred pronouns or whatever, then I'm gonna show your sister this yaoi art that... What's her name?
Mayo, I think it was? Mayo.
Yeah, whatever her name was. Yeah,
It's confusing because Mia from Nichijou...
Yeah, I'll show little sister Chan this deviant art.
Yeah, it's basically the Japanese equivalent of deviant art.
Yeah.
Manga.
Hey, if you're into yaoi and yami, okay, good for you. Not gonna judge. You know what?
Just
don't force your fetishes onto me. No. Okay, so KK, why is it called shortcake? Is that meant to be a joke about the penis? Like, no, he's got a shortcake down.
No,
there.
Short Shoma, and cake Keki.
Ah, okay, yeah, I get it now.
Remember, Keki is cake, but Keki is his name.
That makes a lot more sense.
It's a joke on his name.
Yeah, I get
it. And Shoma, just similar to short.
I don't know how I miss that. So KK treats Saiki like a dog in the I like how you put
it is cute
scene at treating someone. To be honest, I don't really think that she was treated like a dog. It's like this, how you talk to a normal person. Hey buddy, how are you? You doing good there?
Hey buddy.
It's like, oh, how you doing, slugger? You know, then they come up to the kids and they're like, hey buddy, who's a good boy?
Yeah,
I've seen parents when I was a kid.
And
like
in that moment, he's actually...
My dad would do that to me, go like that.
In that moment, he's actually thinking like, oh, this could actually be somewhat normal.
Oh, but you know anything about Sayuki?
And then it gets to the belly rub moment.
Yeah,
where she lifts up her shirt.
It's like rub my belly, senpai. Do it, senpai. Let me just get rid of this water.
Oh my gosh.
Go on. Continue.
I was taking a sip, you ass.
I'm gonna put you away for me.
Nah, I was taking a fucking sip. So, and then the next moment that happens is Sayuki pulling Keke into her boobs.
Oh, yeah. Notice me, senpai. Please notice me, senpai.
And what makes it even worse, Mizuha walks straight in on the situation, and it's just like, it literally looks like KK motorboating Sayuki while she's dressed up like a dog.
It's like, walks in, it's like, yeah, I'm not getting involved in this.
She doesn't even freak out. She's just like, have fun, you two.
Yeah, it's like, open the door. I'm just gonna close the door.
No, she does say something.
Yeah, I forget what it is, though.
It's just like, I'll leave you two to it, basically.
Yeah, but the point I was making was she didn't really care. She was just like, opens it, sees him, it's just like, close the door.
There's a clip, I don't remember what anime it's from, but there's just a funny moment of, like, this guy walks into his room, and there's a girl just in her bra and panties, and he's just like, turns around and just, like bounce squats out of the room.
I don't know what that one is.
I don't remember the anime, but it's in a compilation video.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
But it's just funny, because he's like, bouncing out of the room in that moment.
Where were we?
Yeah. So
Yeah, so KK asks Aiki why he has to be her master, and it's because she sees him as someone worthy of the role. Worthy of the role.
The worthy of the role of taking care of me.
He has to fight for the role. You ever play the old SmackDown versus Raw games?
No.
King of the Hill or something? It's where you're fighting all of the characters in the game, and if you go out of the ring, you're out.
Oh my god.
And so you're fighting everyone, and it's like, okay, the last man in the ring is the winner. And you know who the last man in the ring was in my playthrough?
Who?
John Cena. Nah, it was Undertaker.
So Sayuki leaves the house after the interesting time.
Yeah.
And there is a shot of her just looking over the banister. And it's like looking down at the conversation happening between Keiki and Mizuha, because he calls an emergency family meeting. And that shot is important for later.
Yeah. Remember, I think it was in this episode.
Yeah, it is in this episode.
No, when she makes the food. And you see it's the chicken, right? And that's when the opening?
I don't...
Because I'm pretty sure it's this or last episode.
No, it happens at one point, but...
Yeah, because you see the chicken in the trailer, but you
don't... No, he's mindlessly eating it.
Yeah, because you see it in the trailer, what's on the tray, the chicken.
The karate chicken.
Yeah, and then you see later in an episode, because someone pointed that out to me, and I was like, oh, I didn't notice that.
Yeah, everything in the opening is in an episode.
Everything?
I think everything, because like there was the bowling pin... Bowling.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if the rubber chicken was in there, but...
Yeah. So,
But most of the stuff in the opening appears once. Like, when the two kid versions of Mizuha and Keiki are walking through the shot, there's, like, the ring with the colours. That was in the room.
Oh. Oh, okay.
That was in the Ayano's room that she set up.
I didn't know that. I just noticed the chicken because it looked good.
Yeah, because you got hungry. That's why.
Yeah, that's why.
Gotta do food wars at some point.
Maybe. I got a Fallout cooking book. We'll just have to get. We'll have to one day just come over here. We'll set up the laptop. Just
cook. Oh my gosh!
Well, I was watching this thing with
I've actually found a visual novel game.
Oh, okay.
I will not tell you now. I'll tell you after the video.
Oh yeah. Speaking of video, I was watching this thing, and there's this guy who's like making food, like how he does in Breath of the Wild. And when he's got the pan on, he just like throws the food on there, and he's cooking it away, and then he's eating it. It's like, ugh.
It just tastes horrible.
Yeah. Like he's eating the bananas with the skin on them, just copying the meals.
We gotta get back to this. We're interrupted by Yuka showing up.
Yeah, so Yuka shows up, she's bored.
She's bored, quotation marks. And, exactly the same thing that happened with Seiki, basically.
And it's like, rather than me being a pet, you're going to be my pet, and I want you to be a bunny.
She makes him wear a bunny girl outfit.
She's like, there's no such thing as a bunny guy outfit, is there?
No.
Just a bunny girl. Imagine a bunny guy outfit has to do like a speedo or something.
Oh!
I imagine that's what it would be. Like, you got ears.
And speedo. And then that's it.
Or maybe just like a bunny rabbit just on around the crotch area. Like a rabbit pattern.
Oh, no.
Alright. So, Yuika wants to make KK her slave because it's hard for him to hate her. It's like,
That sort of makes sense in her weird logic.
Because he doesn't hate her, he's just like, he doesn't have a backbone, this guy.
Yeah.
Which is kind of like me. KK
questions Yuka why it's easy for her to give her panties to a boy. But she says she would only do it for Keke.
And Keke's like, wait a minute. Is she actually confessing? Is she telling me?
No, it's more like, does she actually like me? Yeah. Sort of. And then Mizuha walks in again.
Yeah.
Same beat.
And it's like, oh god, okay. How about you put like a little hat on the door or a little sign.
It's an indication of do not enter.
Yeah.
Even just a sock would do. Although, using a sock indicates you're doing that other things.
Yeah, so Mayo knew both Sayuki and Yuika would go to KK's house. And then, because she's looking at them through the telescope she has, right?
No, she just knows. Because they both mentioned it to her.
Episode.
They both mentioned what their plan was to her.
Yeah.
Well, not really. They both Yuika and Sayuki were planning to go to his house that day. Yeah. And Mayo just overheard.
So, this is, like, later in there. KK is driving Mizuha's hair while she sits on his lap. Is this, like, did she just go and have another shower later or something?
I think so. It's, like, later in the day. By the way, I just want to call something out quickly. He calls another emergency family meeting in this episode. And he's still wearing the bunny girl outfit. When he's talking to Mizuha, remember that?
Oh, yeah.
He's just sitting there.
How is it a family meeting when it's just the two of them? Shouldn't it be, like, sibling meeting?
Mm. But, again, Yuika is looking over the banister, so, again, that's an important shot.
Yeah. So, Mizuha is understanding...
Mizuha?
Sorry, Mizuha.
Hold on, I just got a message.
What?
Keep going.
So Mizuha is... are understanding the fact that Sayuki and Yuika are perverts.
Oh! We got someone else joining. Right. I'll get to you. Sorry, I gotta do something else quickly right now.
So, after she leaves in that, KK checks his apartment, like the secret compartment underneath his mattress.
Hey. Oh, come on.
And he notices that his prized possessions have been taken from the compartment.
Hold on. Oh, good.
What's going on?
I'm trying to message my friend right now, telling him that we're doing this. But we got someone to join the chat right now. And they're just laughing.
Sorry.
That's alright.
It's all good.
No, it's alright.
You just joined at an inopportune time.
Yeah. Yes, and the next day, Shoma finds out about the Underella candidates.
Why are you smiling?
What?
I think he's looking at us for the camera.
Are you smiling now?
We're just having a bit of a laugh. That's all. Because right now we are recording a podcast.
A podcast?
Yeah.
I would like to join.
Okay.
God.
I think it's because you're using Amino. That's why you're fine.
Why does this have to keep happening every time I go out of the app? And try to go back into there.
No.
It's just shut the whole thing down.
Amino.
Mm-hmm. God.
Okay. So Tremor's found out KK's.
Oh no, the person just
secret.
Left.
Okay, so he's found out KK's secret. And he knows about the candidates now, and so the two of them just start going over, okay, who could...
Well, he tells her. He tells her what's going on.
No, Shoma's the,
No,
the friend.
But he's talking to Mizuha right now.
Oh, that's not Mizuha. Sorry, I'm thinking of, KK. Sorry, my bad. I got distracted by Mr. Chuckles over here. So, KK notes that, because this is Mizuha, Shoma, and KK are in the same room, right?
No. It's just Mizuha and KK.
Okay. Because it's like, it says here, KK notes that Sayuki was wearing a pink bra and Yuika was wearing pink panties during their first confessions. of their love slash desire.
That's just a coincidence, really.
Yeah, it's plot-driven.
Plot-driven coincidence combined with what was mentioned earlier about pink underwear.
Yeah. So KK's suspect list to who Underella is down to Sayuki and Yuika.
Still no Misaha.
And in order to investigate, he's like, okay, I'm gonna become KK's master.
No,
not really.
No, KK becomes Sayuki's master. Yeah, KK you got it mixed up.
Sorry, KK becomes Sayuki's master. Not really, but it's just a ruse.
It's just for the day.
Yeah, and he needs to know if she's the one that gave him the panty.
Yeah.
Why didn't he just ask her? You know? Because you are my slave awkward. Now, and you will tell me.
It's just awkward. That's all.
Okay.
And so that, I know what happens at the end of the next episode. Yeah. Whew. He gets an eyeful.
Yeah. So that brings us to episode 9. Are we still going? Mm-hmm. Alright, so let me go use the toilet real quick.
Okay.
Alright, you just continue on. I'll be back.
So yeah, Keiki and Sayuki go to an amusement park for their date, which is not a bad option for a date situation. And Keiki turns around, and Keiki is just like, says to Sayuki, hey, you're going to call me master for the whole date. he's going all in for this mission. Yeah, Sayuki doesn't want to. Sayuki is not wanting to go on the roller coaster because he's like, basically what happened at the end of episode 8 is the panties got stolen. The panties got stolen at the end of episode 8, so this is why this is happening in episode 9. And he's trying to use the rides at the roller coaster park to see if she's wearing the panties during their whole date. So the first ride he suggests is the roller coaster, which is really scary. And Sayuki doesn't want to go on it because she's wearing a skirt and worried that the wind will blow it up. But he respects that and then forces her on the ride. And both Heike and Sayuki are like, yeah, let's not go on the roller coaster anymore. Oh, yeah. Both are traumatized by that roller coaster.
Yeah, my dad can't handle roller coasters. You know, like the big spinning ones as well, and you got like, I mean, roller coasters are fine, but you know, sometimes the ones that spin, they go upside down, 360.
Like the hypercoaster at,
yeah,
at Movie World?
Yeah, and he's like, oh, I'm not going on that.
So, Keiki tries many other ideas to see Sayuki's panties, but each one fails in hilarious fashion.
Why doesn't he just get a fan? It's like, oh, it's so hot here, man. I just need to cool down.
And then I go, woo!
Try, bought the skirt.
I don't think that would work, because it would be obvious.
Ah, well, he's got to try something.
And also, we find out why she doesn't want to do certain rides at the end of the episode. So
KK,
it's a good thing he didn't try the fan thing.
Are we there?
In public. Yeah.
Yeah, so KK let... Oh, yeah, that's right. I completely forgot. So KK lets Sayuki choose a ride. Yeah. And she chooses the Ferris wheel.
Which is probably the slowest ride.
Yeah, and I'm not a big fan of the Ferris wheel. My dad's like, oh, shit, yeah, let's go on the Ferris wheel.
A Ferris wheel is just, you just go up there for the views, really.
Yeah, it's cold up there, especially when it's windy, it's cold. You're going to die from hypothermia.
That's why you fart.
Yeah,
it just warms up the whole room.
Nah, the wind just blows it away.
No.
Oh, did you just fart? I don't know, did you?
No.
Okay, I was going to say, I didn't know if you were talking about Ferris.
No, I mean, I get the one you're talking about, the open air ones.
Yeah.
There's the eye in
It's like, who the hell farts in a Ferris wheel, man?
That's almost as disgusting as
someone trying to piss off the side of a Ferris wheel. That's grotesque.
Imagine if you're able to do that and get into the water and not hit anyone. That'd be impressive, in my opinion. It's like, oh, I really need to go.
Don't need to go that bad. So KK gets thwarted by Sayuki licking him on the face
while again
the Ferris wheel.
How many times is this going to lick him on the face?
Yeah, but to his credit, KK, in preparation for the date, did do some research on dog training and obedience, so
and
he has a slight advantage in, like, okay, how can I fool
Sayuki
her?
Knew that he was doing it.
Yeah. And it's like, oh my god, this just shows how much you care for me. You've been looking up how to train me. We're really meant to be together.
So they get off the Ferris wheel and they go to, I think it's a showcase of Shoto riding. And Sayuki's Shoto riding of Evil Spirits is there. And it got,
she entered for the contest. Was selected as one of the best in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, So Sayuki's trigger on choosing KK being her master was when he joined the Shoto Club.
Once again, proving the point that him being nice screwed him in the end.
Yeah, it's like, oh man, you don't want to be nice. Just be an ass your life. That's the only way to live carefree.
No, somehow, I feel like somehow she would still choose him. I don't think there's any way.
I mean, you'd think they'd take, like, if when you'd have enough, you'd be like, no. That's why I like some of those animes where the guy's, like, not interested in the woman. It's just like, oh, I honestly don't care.
Yeah.
I was watching this one, the girl's like, oh, hey. And she goes to jump into his arms, and he just dodges her, and she just falls on the ground and just keeps on walking.
So They're going home at this point, and they're going up to a bridge that goes over the road. And KK is like, just figures out, oh, I'll use my roll to actually just get it to lift her skirt up.
Yeah, it's like, oi,
like,
bitch.
You had the whole,
yeah,
you
like,
had the whole day, man.
Whole day, he wasted hours, like, it's like,
he wasn't
But he
direct. Had fun with those few hours, though.
Yeah. So he's like, okay, I need to see what panties you're wearing. And like a scene from Dragon Ball.
What?
You remember that scene in Dragon Ball?
I haven't watched Dragon Ball.
Oh, basically it's a scene and Master Roshi's like, okay, I'll give you this freestyle Dragon Ball if you show me your panties. And what's happened is Goku's actually removed them from the night before and she doesn't know that she's not wearing them. And she's like, okay, here you go. And she flashes him. She doesn't realize he's like naked down there. It's like, oh.
And she gets the ball.
She gets the ball.
Well,
it's funny. Goku's freaking out. He's like, oh, you have no balls. And she's like, the Dragon Balls are gone.
And then,
yeah,
but
so
yeah, this basically happens to Keke, though. He gets an eye full of, bush.
Yeah. Or not, depending on, like, what's... I don't know what's going on down there.
I just say bush, just in general, just to keep it on the safe side.
George Bush?
No, just bush.
Yeah. So, where were we?
We're here.
Because
I messed up running.
So Sayuki took the whole night to realize not wearing panties during the date was a bad idea.
No, we're here.
Keke asked Mizuha if girls ever
have the urge to go commando.
She's like, what? I'm not answering that.
I had a bad moment where I forgot to grab underwear when I went to the gym.
Oh, man.
And I had to go commando in my shorts.
God, I can't do that. My boys need a house. They need four walls and a roof.
And I'll just say right now, I understand why Mizuha doesn't.
Yeah, I don't want to understand that. So Sayuki took the whole night to realize not wearing panties during the date was a bad idea, you think?
Yeah, especially if obviously.
It's like, if you're wearing pants, okay, but she's wearing the skirt, you know?
Yeah.
What if the wind blows? It's like, okay.
Whoop! Oh, damn. Arrogancy, mate!
Of course, you got people wearing bras now, just as a shirt, so...
Yeah.
I don't know.
There's a
Flintstones slash... And not the gym bras, I mean, like, the sports bras and all that.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like, oh, okay, yeah, I guess those are the norm now.
There's a Flintstones or Scooby-Doo reference in this...
What was the reference?
Literally right there, really, really... Really dearly do.
Really dearly do.
Yeah.
Yeah, Flintstones. Yabba-dabba-doo.
But also, Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Yeah, Scooby-Dooby-Doo. Yeah, but when Fred's happy, he goes, yabba-dabba-doo.
But you get what I mean, right? It's sort of both.
No, I'm happy.
Because Scooby-Dooby-Doo. It ends in do. Both end in do.
Yeah, but I'm guessing it's Flintstones rather than Scooby-Doo.
It could be either.
I mean, it could, but I'm pretty sure it's this one size.
Yeah.
So Yuika asked KK for help with math in preparation for the final exam, which, did you know math is racist?
What?
I don't know. They're saying in America now that math is racist, and I don't know. It's something about, like, because Asian people are so good at it. It's like, how is that racist? Their parents make them study. Before they do anything else.
I see the problem now.
Yeah, it's not their fault that they want their kids to have a good education, you know?
Yeah.
Just I suck at math, okay? I can't do algebra for shit. I can do plus, times, divide, you know, minus that.
Yeah.
A few square roots, but no, algebra is just like over me.
This is probably one of my favorite moments in the whole,
I think I know what you're gonna say.
The moment where when Sayuki's running patients really, really small.
Yeah.
And she's running in kanji, and she's doing it perfect.
Okay, I did not think that was what you were gonna say. Riding patients.
Yeah, but just the fact that she goes off the paper onto the mat and finally onto the wood. The reason why I'm amazed by this is it looks like almost photorealistic in the sense. Because, like, on the paper, it's like there's a soft blur to it. On the mat, there's a very hard blur. And then on the hardwood, on the wood, it's so perfect. It's like there's no blur at all.
No blur at all.
Because paper, paper has ridges. Yeah. The mat has way more ridges. And then the wood is, like, smooth.
Okay, yeah, I'm just trying to remember.
And it's just, like, the perfect demonstration of how terrifying. Like, it looks really good, and how good Sayuki is at writing kanji. Yeah. Like, if you're able to write that for small, perfectly spaced and all that, what the frick?
You must be a machine.
Yeah. And she does it perfectly. Like, even on the mat, you can tell it's perfect.
I honestly can't remember that thing.
When Keiki's helping Yuka with the mat with her math. It's in that moment. She's trying to, like, panic.
Vaguely, I mostly remember the lewd stuff.
But it goes to show that the best moment is not even a lewd thing.
Yeah. So Sayuki, are we doing that one here, or are we just talk about the
panic? I just talked about that one because that was a side note that I put there.
So Sayuki almost loses it at Yuika for being all over KK.
Okay.
And it's like, how could you? I'm his pet. You don't get to dominate.
And then
he's dominating me.
And then she ignores him.
Yeah.
Because Sayuki thinks KK was playing hard to get, but he's not. He's caught up in this sex struggle.
Yeah. these sexapades of his.
Yeah.
And there's no sex going on, but you know what I mean.
Yeah.
These escapades of raunchiness, which he has no way of escaping. Sayuki stole that one?
No.
Top one. Sayuki was counting on KK spanking her after her underwear free day, but
why?
That did not happen. What
spanking?
I don't know.
Why spanking?
I mean, was she a bad girl or something? I don't know.
She didn't wear the underwear. A bad bitch?
Yeah, because he didn't get the answer he wanted, so she has to be punished or something. And Sayuki stole some of his underwear and wore them to school, which he's clearly annoyed at. And it's like, well, if you want them back, you're going to have to take them. And he's like, oh, no, you keep them. Well, no, yeah. It's not what happens, but...
Yeah, but... That means she didn't steal the panties.
Yeah. Then who did? So, KK walks Yuika to her house in the rain since... Well, we already know who stole the panties. But...
Yeah, we already know, but we're trying to keep the mystery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, KK walks Yuika to her house in the rain since she forgot her panty-brella.
Umbrella.
Under-brella.
Breaking nose.
Okay. So Yuika invites KK in after he shows the first sign of catching a cold and gets him a hot drink.
And he's like, oh, this is a perfect chance to find out if she stole the panties.
Yeah, so he's sneaking around Yuika's room. And he ends up getting caught like an idiot.
And he's not even caring. He's like, yeah, I'm just looking around.
And then Yuika's like, listen well, bitch. You're gonna be my slave. Otherwise, I'm gonna tell people about your panty snooping. And it's not like she has any proof anyway.
What?
She doesn't have any proof. It's like her word against his.
So she took a photo.
Yeah, one photo. What's to stop him from just reaching over, grabbing the phone, deleting it, and getting out of the house?
Well, he doesn't.
And because if he did that, then it'd be her word against his. Mm-hmm. It'd be like, oh, who are people going to believe?
Well, he doesn't do that and is now in...
Now he's a slave. So, that's the end of episode 9. We're on episode 10 now. Should we just stop it here?
Yeah, do the last three episodes... Next week?
Yeah, so that leaves 1, 2, 3, 4.
No. That page there is the next anime.
Okay.
We're only at 4 pages left. Well, it's actually more like 3.5.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. But we're sort of through, like, the most kinky part of the anime.
Oh, yeah. Wait, I think I know which part you're talking about. That's in episode...
No, we're 11. Through...
Oh, I thought you said we're getting up to the most kinky. Oh, no, that's already happened. Sorry.
Yeah, we're through most of the kinky stuff.
I was thinking of something that already happened.
A lot of the stuff towards the end is a lot more tame.
Yeah. Yeah, by this show standards.
Yeah. Like, really, there's not much left.
Yeah.
And somehow, and it's going to wrap up somehow as well.
Yeah.
And then, like, it wraps up in, like, 2 episodes, and then the last episode is just, like, him coming to terms with the whole thing.
And she's like, oh, you know what, I'm going to be stuck in this situation. Might as well make the best of it. Let's make a harem. Then, boom, we got the next season. Which, no, that doesn't happen, but...
No. You know what does happen? Ending this episode right now.
Yeah.
Links will be in the description to both my channels and also Bailey's channel, Total Gamer Junkie.
Yeah, you're gonna have to censor my name now.
What?
You're gonna have to edit it out. You said my name.
Why?
I was making a joke because you don't want your name said.
So and like, I do use my actual name on my second channel. Just not here.
It's a secret.
Well, if you watch my second channel, you know what it is.
Yeah.
Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know when the next video comes out. A ding, a ding, ding.
Dong.
Guy!
Oh, yeah, he knows what I did right there.
Don't you dare point at my dog. Dog. I'm a mad scientist. Mad scientist out.
See you next week, everybody.